Okay, question for you. Yesterday evening I've uploaded Joomla 3.9.13 to my area on the web server with FileZilla. Here I can see where it is on the server. Who can tell me which address I need to type into my browser to see my Joomla installation? You're welcome to come closer to the screen. Or anybody remembers the Windows 10 thing to zoom in? Is there like a button you press twice and it zooms in? Anybody knows? Top left hand corner. No, there's a button or something you press twice and it zooms in. Anyway, doesn't matter. Not sure how it works. So, any volunteers? Anybody who wants to come to the front? Let me have a quick look whether I find out how to zoom in. Windows 10, zoom in. Zoom shortcut. There's Windows logo key and the plus sign. Okay, let's try that. Yay, works, it working. Okay, so who can tell me what address I have to type in? Yeah, okay, thank you. That's exactly the answer I was after. Okay, I'll open a new window. Okay, here we are. So, cms.bimserver2.com/joomla3.9.13. Okay. Let's zoom in a bit. Okay, so just to get you warmed up, what am I seeing here, the front end or the back end? Yeah, okay. And I haven't installed any sample data. I think most of you, or maybe all of you, have installed sample data. So you'll already see some pages. I haven't installed sample data, which makes it more difficult for me now to set up anything. So let's try to create a web page. So I want to go to the back end. What should I do? How, where? Here? Okay. This will lock me on to the front end. Now, depending on how I set things up, I can do certain things on the front end. I might be able to create articles or edit articles, but I can't do all the things I need to do. For some of the things, I need to go to the back end. So the back end, I'll open it in a new tab. So I open a new tab. And it's the address of the front end followed by, anybody knows? Administrator. Okay, here we are. So, now I've got one tab with my front end, one tab with my back end. I need to log on. Just to keep it simple, I left the username admin. It's arguable whether that's a good choice in the real world, because if there was anybody trying to hack into your system, they might just try admin. So, you know. That's whatever I set up when I installed it, you know, on the first. Administrator, yeah. In the URL, yeah. Okay, here we are, maybe in the back end. I'll zoom out a bit. Okay, Joomla would like permission to collect some basic statistics. Yeah, I'm fine with that. You know, I'm grateful enough that they gave me Joomla for free. They can have my statistics. Okay, I'll zoom out a bit. Oops. Okay, what should our website be about? Anybody who wants to volunteer their hobby? You can make a web page about your hobby. Who has a hobby? Twitter viewers? Okay. What's it called? It's drifting, yeah. It's like there's a Sega arcade machine, isn't there?
Where you, Tokyo Drift Spoiler.
Is it that one? I know once I was in a ferry and then the game was like this, that, you know, so you are the main driver and your girlfriend keeps telling you what you have to do, and then you get then a little hearts above her head if you do the right kind of drift or whatever. so we do a web page about drifting. Okay, so are there different types of drifting?
Not really, it's mainly track. There's different levels of competition.
Mm-hmm. So what kind of, so we could have a welcome page.
Mm-hmm.
Let's write that down on the board. So now that you all know what drifting is, what makes sense for our drifting website? Yeah. So not the kind of drifting when we start daydreaming in class, but the kind of drifting where you pull the handbrake on your car and then it moves in donut-shaped circles or whatever the car does. So we want a welcome page. What else do we want? How to drift, instructions for the apprentice or for the novice. How to drift. What else could we do?
Maybe I'll then a competitive drifting.
Yeah?
Sort of main page that you could have some sub-pages on.
So this is just one page, yeah?
Yeah.
And how to drift is one page. This is some, actually this is part of the welcome area, is it? Okay, so we have competitive drifting. I remember watching a video, was it a Top Gear or something, and then they complained that with the new cars with electric handbrakes you can't drift anymore.
That was one of the, there have been three different drives on that, they spoke competing in one of the series.
Oh yeah.
They're only really young. So you've got grassroots drifting, which is like sort of entry level.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you've got national series, you've got the European series, and then you've got a worldwide series as well.
Well, last time I did any drifting was on a car park in the 90s, in the mid 90s. Actually, my friend did most of the drifting with my car. He was good at it. Okay, so let's start with this. Okay, we want a welcome page. So let's all figure out together how to create a page. So here's my control panel. I'll show you the menus at the top. You might have looked at them last week, but just in case. So we've got this button here that will always bring us back to this back-end landing page. Some information for you, like what happened last, like the user admin logged in, if you have, let's say, five different people. Now you've got different users logging on, and then you can see whichever user logged on. Here are some shortcuts, new articles, categories, and so on. Then here we've got a drop-down menu for all the system messages. Global configuration, so many things are set by default, for example. Let's have a look there. Let's do a specific example. Here's the global configuration. Lots of things you can set up. For example, you can change the site name. So This is the length drifting crew. So I can take the site offline, you know, then visitors see some message, something like the site is offline for maintenance. I can save this. You always have those buttons here. Can you see them? I'll try to zoom in a bit more. Yeah. You always have save. Then you save the changes you made on this page, but you stay on the page. You can do save and close. You save the changes you've made, but you go out of the screen, or you can click on cancel. Let's say you made some changes you don't want to keep. Now, if I make a change, then now I haven't saved yet, which means if I go away, then we don't know what's going on. So please get used to when you make any changes before you move away, press save. The system is much better than it used to be in trying to prevent you from having modifications that haven't been saved. But you can still basically modify something, close down the browser window, and the system doesn't know what's going on. Example, let's say, you were just editing a drifting web page, but then, you know, somebody calls and you close down your browser web page and you haven't saved it. What happened is when you started editing the drifting web page, the page got locked because we don't want two users modifying it at the same time. But you close down the browser window, so we have this situation now where the page is locked. Nobody else can go in, but because you close down the browser window, you can never save it either. Let's say you then want to go there and you want to modify it, you can't. Yeah. Then some sort of admin needs to come and needs to unlock the page. And so there's some mechanisms built in to prevent you from messing things up by working on the same thing at the same time. In reality, you won't have that problem that much because you'll probably be the only person working on your CMS. But in a real example, in a real company, that can be an issue. So always remember to save things. Yeah. In your case, you've got admin permissions. You can unlock anything that has been locked by mistake. Yeah, so there are lots of things here I can change in the settings. Yeah, I can change things on this, on the, about the system, about the server, or all sorts of things, lots of things I can change here. Okay, here then we've got global check-in, let's say, you know, if there are lots of pages checked out, which means they're locked because somebody checked them out, you can undo that all. Here, this is where we manage users. So in reality, we will have many users. And the idea is that even though we might have 20 users working on this web page, and they might have different permissions, they usually resemble each other. Yeah? Let's say if we have Drifting Pete and Vauxhall Susie, and you know, they might have similar permissions in our page. We don't need to set up a specific account with unusual permissions for Drifting Pete, and they might be super different to Vauxhall Susie or whatever we might have. So we want to group users together in different groups. Is there a difference between front wheel drive and back wheel drive?
Okay.
It has to be the real drive. You can't do this thing with front wheel drive. No, you can.
You can scan it.
Okay. Oh, I didn't know that. Okay, what about when we have... So I was skidding, not lifting. So you need a BMW or something like that?
Yeah, it has to be a BMW. You also push it.
And all wheel drive, four wheel drive?
You can, but...
Because you're now I get it.
So it depends.
You're accelerating while the head plate is on. I thought you... Oh, okay, okay.
Convert usually you just use to lose attraction.
And then they're now front wheel drive cars with the handbrake blocking the back wheel.
Well, no, because you...
No.
You're not driving.
Okay, so let's say we have... what's it, the other one called? Skidding and drifting. Yeah?
It's skid as well.
Skid, yeah. Okay, so we have... Let's say the skidders and the drifters, they are not the best friends with each other. So we don't want the skidders to be able to edit the pace of the drifters and the other way around. Yeah? So we can create different groups, and we can then decide who's in which group. Yeah? So is Drifting Pete, is he a skidder? Is he a drifter? And we put them in this group. And we can then say everybody in this group has those permissions. Yeah? All the people in the drifting group can edit all the drifting pages, but they don't have permission to edit the skidding pages, and the other way around. Does that make sense? So this is the bread and butter of managing user accounts in any kind of system, you know, whether you're managing a server and so on. So I think it's very likely that you'll end up in a company, they have a web page, and once they figure out, well, you know, I think the chances are nearly 100% that you end up in a company with a web page. But once they figure out that you know this kind of stuff, and if they're a small company, there's a good chance they'll let you do some of that stuff. I told you before, I see people at graduation and they tell me, oh, well, your module was really useful because now I'm doing... This is part of my job, this kind of stuff. Okay, so this is where we set it up. We create users and we assign users to groups. Menus, yeah, this is where we manage the menus that people see on the front end. What else do we have? Content, yeah, this is where we write the articles. And an interesting point here, the same way as users are grouped together, in groups, articles are grouped together in categories. And you remember I talked about Drupal? And in Drupal we tag things. Anybody here using Gmail? Yeah. If you use Gmail, Google Mail, if you get an email, you can tag the email. You don't really put the email in a folder, in a category. Yeah. So the advantage is, let's say you get an invoice about your car, then you can put the tag invoice on, and you can put it on all the emails you get with invoices, whether it's for your pet or for your car. So you can put the invoice tag on and you can put the car tag on. Yeah. Whereas Outlook, you all know Outlook from Uclan, you put an email in a folder. Yeah. Your email is going to be in the invoice folder or in the car folder. It's not going to be, it can't be in both folders at the same time. Drupal works more with tags. Joomla works with categories. You can also use tags, but you know the default way of organizing things in Joomla is with categories. Then we've got components. That's where basically we put all the add-ons. Let's say we want an image gallery for all our drifting pictures. We can install an image gallery and we can access it possibly here under components or under extensions. And here under extensions we also control the templates. I'll show you later when we have a bit of a content, because at the moment if I change the template, it's not as impressive as down the line when we have some content. Okay, so I want to create a welcome page. Where do you think do I go? Can you see this or should I zoom in more?
No,
it's fine. Good. So there's no wrong answer here. You know, you haven't learned how to do it yet. So this is more about we try to figure it out together. There are no wrong answers. You tell me what I should try to do and then I try to do it, and if it doesn't work, we think what we could change. So I want to create a welcome page.
Content.
Let's try content. No? And now?
Articles.
Okay. So, welcome to the okay, here's my content. Okay. Now I'm lazy. I'll just take some content from Wikipedia. Oh, it's a sport even officially. Okay, here? Yeah? Okay. So I copy to the text. I put a little thing there. The content is from Wikipedia. And, you know, if you want to see who wrote the article, you can check here in Wikipedia directly. Yeah. We could put a picture in. We could use something like this. Yeah. Yeah, you can use it. So if you use pictures, better you don't steal images. I will not check where you took your image from, but there are lots of images on the internet with permissions like this, you know, Creative Commons license, where you are legally allowed to use the picture. All you need to do is put a little copyright thing at the bottom, like here in this case, this picture has been created by the Polytechnic University of Milan. So you can just use this, put a little thing at the bottom to comply with the Creative Commons license. Yeah. You want to see how to put the picture in, or should we just leave the text for now? Picture in? Okay. Okay, if you want to be absolutely sure how it works with this license, you know, you click here. Now it will tell you what you're allowed to do. Are we allowed to share it? We can redistribute it, which means we are legally allowed to put it on our website. We must give appropriate credit. Provide a link to the license and indicate if changes were made. Okay, we didn't make any changes. So very basically, we just need to credit the Polytechnic University of Milan and link to this page. And then, you know, we took this picture. Yeah, there are no additional restrictions, so even if we were to earn money with our web page, that would be fine. So I'm gonna save this picture. Now, this picture, did I talk about image formats? No, I'll talk about it in one of the next weeks. Interestingly enough, this picture is a vector format, which basically means we can zoom in as much as we want. It never gets pixely. But I don't think I don't know whether Joomla can handle vector formats. So I just copy this current version, which means I save it as a PNG image. I'll talk about those image formats another time. PNG. So I'm just, I'll cover that next week, so let's just forget about that for now. Okay, I'll save my page for now. Okay. And I want to upload my image first. Where do you think do I go to upload my image? You think it's system, user, menu, content, components, extensions, or help? Content, media, yeah. Okay, and you can see here, and maybe because of the way I zoomed in, it looks a bit funny. Let me zoom out. Okay, there are different folders. I can create more folders. Yeah, so I can arrange all my media by folders. Any folder structure you can think of for our website? I could have like a folder for skidding and one for drifting. Skidding. Here we are. Maybe I should have kept it lowercase. Anyway, now I've done it uppercase. Drifting. Okay, and this is a drifting picture. So I go into the drifting folder. Here's an upload button. I choose the file. Here we are. Start upload. Yeah. Here we are. Okay, good. So I go back to my article. Where do I go? Content, articles. Yeah, and here it is. Okay, and now I want to put the picture in. So there are many ways of doing that. Here's an icon here, insert, edit image. There's an icon here called image. They all work slightly differently. There's a whole tab here for images. Yeah. So it's something for you to figure out. What's the difference between all those different ways of putting a picture in? Here I've got insert media, insert image. Yeah. So you've already seen four different ways of inserting images. Some of them are the same. Yeah. Here, for example, I could put an address in of the picture directly on the Wikipedia page. Here I can have an article image. So that's something nice for you to find out basically what the difference is. Put this one in. Yeah. And if you want to have there we are. Okay. You can set it up here in the article. Image description. So image description is you might have somebody who is visually impaired, who is a screen reader, or somebody with a very poor internet connection. You can write down what's in this picture, and then that will help them. Their screen reader might be able to read it to them. So, caption, I'm just gonna copy this. Yeah. Insert, and here we are. Okay. Okay, I save the page. Save and close. Yeah. I refresh my front end, and I can't see the picture, the article, sorry. Yeah. The name of the page has changed, but even though there's an article here, I still can't see it, yeah? So we created the article, but the article isn't any way linked to the front end yet. You can create hundreds of articles, but they will not be visible until you make them accessible. So there are several ways of doing this. In the end, you have lots of articles, and you have a few menus here. So one straightforward way is, you have a few, sorry, I said menus. In Joomla language, we should call them menu items. So this is a menu, and the menu consists of menu items. So I can create many menu items here, for example, welcome, skidding, drifting, or your competitive drifting, things like that. A very common approach is the following. You put, I'll make some space again. You put an article into a category. And there might be many articles in that category. And your menu item then basically shows you everything in this category. You can also use tags. So you can tag articles. But you always have to assign a category to an article. There's one default category, which is called uncategorized. So theoretically, you could get away with not using categories at all, putting everything in this uncategorized category, and then doing menu items by linking to tags. That's also possible. But I think most people use categories. Okay, so the first thing I need to do now is, if you want to follow this approach, I need to create a category for the article. And if you look here, I hope you can see it, it says category uncategorized. Yeah, because we didn't pick a category, the article was put into the default category. You can rename it if you want. Uncategorized is not a nice name. You could call it general or other or whatever you want. Okay, where do you think do I create categories?
Which menu item?
System, users, menus, content, components.
Let's try that.
Yeah, categories, here we are. Okay, let's create a few additional categories.
So tell me a name of a category I should create.
This web page is all of our web page, so we all take some ownership. What category should we have?
We discussed two or three before. There's no long answer.
Oh, well, it's by consent, what we all agree on.
So somebody make a suggestion and then we'll discuss whether it's a good idea. What could be a name of a category for our drifting website?
Any suggestions? So actually, the categories are purely an internal mechanism. So actually, the users, unless you want to make the users see what categories you use, they don't have, they won't see it. It's an internal mechanism. You could call it Apple Pear Raspberry, but obviously it would make life difficult for you if there's a disconnect between the name of the category and what it actually does. But this is an internal mechanism of grouping things together.
So could one be like information?
Okay, and so and some others? Yeah, but what you actually group together in categories is articles. So categories are just there to group articles together. So I'm saying that because if we call it pictures or whatever, we wouldn't use it to group pictures together. We only use it to group articles together.
So could you have one called information?
Yeah, we could have one called information.
That has like all the information.
But then, are there articles that do not contain information? My question is because I don't know what you think information is. You know, everybody here will hear the word information. We all have a different idea in our head what information is. So if we take the very widest idea of what information is, then you could argue that every single article on our page will contain information.
So could you do what other types of drifting?
So we said drifting and skipping could be categories. So, for example, welcome articles or how-tos, should they be a category? It's up to you, but this is basically, these are some of the headaches you have with your own site. You know, whether you're doing it about knitting or drifting or, you know, for your local trippy or whatever you do. You know, what categories will you use? And there's no perfect answer. It's just whatever you think makes sense.
So, I don't really know about drifting, but say if it's about music.
Yeah.
So, like, would a category be like instruments, then what could be like singers?
Yeah, well, that makes sense, yeah. The whole thing then also links to permissions. And because we want different user groups with different permissions. So there can be a link there, we'll look at that later. So we'll just start now with some categories, but down the line when we know the system better, we might think actually something else makes more sense. That's why it's good we do some practice now, and you have your Joomla practice installation. Because once you get to know the system better, you might think, oh, I should have done the categories different, and then when you do your second installation, for the wider, then you'll be in a better starting position and you don't have to clean up any mess you might have made because you know what's going on. And since I just mentioned the vivas, do you all have a viva date? I sent the email invitations out yesterday in Outlook. Did you get one? Mm-hmm. Have a look whether you got an Outlook invitation for a viva, and if not, tell me. Oh, good. So you should all have one now. Okay, so.
If you already booked it, I didn't get an email yesterday.
You already booked, if you already booked it with me, you didn't get an email, yeah. So we said there's drifting. And here I can write a description of the category if I want. Here there are different options I can set and so on. And this is very interesting here. Look, there's a tab called permissions. And this is where I will basically decide which user group has what kind of permissions. Yeah. We are not usually setting in any system. We don't try to set permissions on a user basis. We try to group users together into groups of people with similar permissions with similar requirements. So I could create a group called drifters, and then I can give the drifters permission to work in this category. But then when I create the skidding category, I don't give the drifters permission if I don't want them to have permissions. So this is very important. Yeah. So categories link to the user groups because you can assign permissions to user groups through the categories. And for the purpose of our assessment, I want different users part of different groups that have different permissions. Even though in reality, you know, your CMS, it's only you editing, we pretend, you know, there are a few people working on it, and some can do X, some can do Y. Now Joomla is quite flexible. You can say the people in the drifter group can do everything drifting. The people in the skidding group can do everything skidding. But you can also do it in a different way. You can say this is a content contributor. He can write articles, but we don't trust whether the articles are any good. So we've got somebody who writes the article, somebody else who then edits the articles, you know, who makes sure they comply with your style guides. Yeah. An example is Adobe has a new style guide that came into effect 1 or 2 months ago. They don't any titles, any headings, they don't want to see the words capitalized anymore. Yeah. So let's say
Category.
Yeah, you might have a rule that you don't want to see anything like that. For easier legibility, you only want basically case, what's it called? Anyway, there's a word for it. Basically, only the first word in the sentence is capital. Sentence case, yeah. And all the others should be lowercase. Yeah, you might have a rule like that. So you could have people who can write articles, but some editors go over it, yeah? Maybe you don't like to see exclamation marks. Yeah. Or maybe you don't trust whether the people can spell words properly. Or maybe some people always put hyphens in between drifting and competition and you don't like to see that. Yeah. So you can set it up however you want. You can have writers and editors, they can then edit it, and somebody else is the publisher. And only they can make it visible to the public. Now you can set up a whole mechanism like in a newspaper, or you could say, oh, the drifters can do everything drifting, including writing and publishing, and the skidders can do everything skidding.
Do you know before in January,
yeah,
where we have like grade matches to what we need on our website to how to
make
a grade?
Yeah. I think there's a marking scheme with the handout. The important thing is basically the make or break between you getting a first and you getting something that's not a first is, can you answer my 2 questions? I will give you 2 questions, something like, you know, create a user that can only do X. And then create a user that can only do Y and can't do Z. Or we'll ask something like, create an article, let's say there's the drifting competition, there's the big Blackburn drifting competition on 1st of December, and I want you to have a big page there. Come and see us at the, you know, Blackburn drifting competition.
So we have to show you that when you click.
Yeah.
So say we go into the website, then you say,
Yeah. First you show me your website, and I'm sure I've seen everything you've done.
Yeah.
You can tell me any issues you had, you can also write them down, and maybe I can reward you for any special thing I otherwise wouldn't have seen.
So just making a website and the tune of the movie.
Yeah.
It's about anything in there.
Yeah. And if you're not sure, you talk to me, then I tell you whether whatever you want to do is a good idea or not.
Can you get on this award? Yeah.
Yeah. Everywhere, you know, it's on the internet, so you can access it anywhere in the world as long as you've got internet connection. And much like in North Korea, where they might not give you access to this page, but
you can do it from anywhere.
So I asked what you did this morning, for example, so you create categories. So it's like, for example, this morning they say how to do the categories, and then you create a
When we do this test, you need to know how to do it yourself.
Yeah, you just need to know how you how to work your own website, basically.
Yeah.
So say that it was category, and you say this is how you do it. Like, if you ask us to make a category, we show it. That could be one of the questions.
I will say, let's say it's a 15 web page. So let's say, I say create a user called, Volvo dead mother, and then we put a user called Volvo dead mother, and she's supposed to only do things in the Volvo category and not in the Volkswagen category or something like that.
We've not learned about users yet.
No, we haven't yet, but we still have a few months to do that.
Yeah.
And this is our first week where we actually look at Joomla. But from now we'll always look at Joomla.
On these diamonds, you said you're not bothered about if it's not the first year.
Yeah.
And here it says about subscription review or what it's going to have to optimize it, but what will also help.
Yeah.
That's what you said.
So you really mark us on the look on the website?
Yeah, that's what you said, you're not bothered.
I'm not bad at it, but it's fine. It's about functionality.
Yeah, and you said what will also count, but you were saying that don't be spending age on how it looks.
But to me, both statements don't interfere with each other. I don't see a discrepancy between this and this person. The main thing is the functionality.
Yeah.
Now, if you are a first-class grade anyway, and you can answer both questions, then how can I distinguish whether it does everything it should, and you can answer all my questions, maybe the look makes another 5% difference. But the functionality is the main thing.
Okay.
So it's just as a ballpoint figure, a good and a bad look makes maybe 5% difference, maybe maximum 10% difference.
Okay.
But I tell you, creating a nice look is a lot of effort. So it's your efforts are much better spent improving the functionality. Because improving the looks can take forever. And then who says your taste is the taste of everybody else?
And you
never taught you how to make something look nice, so I think it would be unfair to put any big emphasis on the looks, because how should you know what I want to do, and so it's very subjective. Well, theoretically you could show me this one when you do the assessment, but I think the best thing is you think this is effective, then you don't feel... If you think this is the real one, you'll always be very careful in case you mess it up. And the truth is, you will create categories, you will create groups that you don't need in the end. Plus, you install the sample data, which means your whole backend is clogged up with categories you're never going to use at all. So, personally, I think the best thing is this is your test, and once you finish whatever you install it, you install a fresh one without sample data like this one.
Well, we do that in class,
sometimes. We can do it in class, But in reality, I can't stop anyone from showing me this and saying this is my final submission.
There's no harm with that, is there? I want you to know.
Well, the thing is, your backend is, if you install the sample data, look how clean my sample data is. Look how clean my backend is. Yeah. No categories here that are unused, no users that are unused, no articles that are unused. Whereas because you installed the sample data, you will probably have two or three pages of articles that you're never going to use.
So how do you get the sample data? How do we get the version of the sample data?
Yeah, you reinstall Joomla into another folder.
Oh.
By that time you know what your CMS will be about, so you can have a nice version.
I think it's less confusing without the sample data.
I think so, but I think it's easier to get started with the sample data. But look at the alternative is this. You wrote an article and you can't even see the article.
Yeah,
Yes,
you see?
A part in the sample.
But in the sample, you can modify an article.
Yeah,
everybody
yeah.
is different.
Yeah, yeah.
This is my suggestion. I get your point.
I prefer from that. To that.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
One article in there. I just need to work around
yeah.
Once I just put that in,
I completely get your point.
Yeah. That's just my
argument. But the alternative is you have something like this. You write an article and you might think, I just wrote an article, why don't I see it? Whereas with sample data you can I completely agree. Sample data is not the best start for everybody, but I thought it's more likely to help you understand what's going on because you can see something. Well, I think we're at the point where we can just stop it now and we just go to the computer room. I've got a task for you on Blackboard. Basically, the first task today is that you should install